rising up from the banks of the Hudson River, a most magnificent metropolis, New York. Endless corridors of concrete and steel, teeming with life. Though fiercely competitive, the crowded streets offer infinite possibilities. And so, in the search for a mate, one must learn how to stand out amongst the masses. Here, we find an ordinary male. Unremarkable in every way, he nearly disappears into the crowd. Manhattan can be lonely for a male of this stature. For left to his own merit, he cannot garner the attention of passing females. Lucky for him, he has developed a strategy with the help of a secret weapon. Despite being a little stubborn, rather unwieldy, and more than a little rambunctious, a dog of this size and character draws special attention from those passing by. And so, he is the perfect lure. Having attracted a potential mate, even a little misbehaving can be ignored. For man's best friend has irresistible charms. He has served his master well and provided a rare opportunity to reproduce. But a decoy is only as effective as its ability to attract attention. Here in Washington Square Park, a guitarist's call carries out across the air. Projecting his song gives him the chance to draw notice from a larger arena. Today, the object of his affection is well within earshot. From this proximity, he easily catches her attention. Emboldened, he begins his sweet serenade.
And I wonder, where will we meet? Maybe you're just sitting on a bench or walking down the street and...
But this budding courtship is interrupted by the call of a nearby rival, making his presence known. Just a stone's throw away, he cannot be ignored, and his call is much more impressive. On this highly competitive stage, merely having a strategy does not guarantee success. He who makes the most noise attracts the most interest. As day turns to night, the landscape becomes even more cutthroat. But not all choose to compete with one another. In fact, it can be highly effective to collaborate and hunt in a pack. Working together benefits each participant separately. When the alpha strikes, his compadres make his presence appear less predatory, and so there's less of a chance of scaring off a potential partner. The beta, carrying none of the responsibility, can sit back and assess the situation before committing to a plan of attack. For those less confident, being in a group guarantees a spot at the marketplace that they otherwise may not have had. In the case of the females, there is safety in numbers, and it becomes easier to slip away from pursuers. But sometimes, one must separate themselves from the herd in order to make a more personal connection. These remarkable tactics work surprisingly well. But unfortunately, not every participant can make a sale. In the sea, animals need only release their eggs and sperm in the water, mixing the two together. On dry land, this proves much more difficult. Finding a mate is only the beginning of courtship. To form a bond, the female must not only test sexual compatibility, but also her partner's commitment. And she does this by inviting him to join her in a sort of ritualized dance. If he accepts her challenge, he must take initiative and make the next move. To prove his worth, he has prepared for her a gift, a display of his potential offerings as a mate. Not to be outdone, she responds, in turn, with a gift of her own. But if she is to be sure of his intentions, she cannot appear too eager, and she must retreat. The sequence of movements is both long and complicated, and at times the two may even appear to duel. But every pas de deux is merely a test of their unity. If both parties perform in harmony and without mistake, they will begin to nest. Now paired, they'll stay together from several weeks to several years. And if they're lucky, they'll pair for life. For the ultimate goal of any animal is to spread their genetic material. And child rearing is no easy task. It takes time, attention, and patience. And so the trials and tribulations of finding a suitable partner have been well worth the struggle, as caring for offspring in this extraordinary city is a job for two.